and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, He made the seas, He made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the valleys are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Stories of the Bible. Adam and Eve sin. This is Adam.
Hey.
And this is Eve.
Hi.
Who were the first people on earth. They lived in the Garden of Eden, which was a beautiful place that had everything they needed. Adam and Eve took care of the animals and could eat from any of the trees in the garden, except for one. This was the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, and God told them not to eat from this tree. There were lots of animals in the garden, but the serpent was the most clever of all the wild animals God had made. One day, he asked the woman,
"Hey, Eve,
did God really say you must not eat the fruit from any of these trees in the garden?" Eve said that they were able to eat from all of the fruit trees except the fruit from the tree in the middle of the garden. For God said, "You must not eat or even touch it. If you do, you will die."
"No, that can't be."
"You won't die," said the serpent. "God knows that as soon as you eat it, you will be like God, knowing both good and evil."
Oh.
The woman was convinced. She saw that the tree was beautiful and its fruit looked delicious, and she wanted the wisdom it would give her. So she took some of the fruit and ate it. Then she gave some to Adam and he ate it too. At that moment, their eyes were opened.
"Oh no!"
And they suddenly realized they weren't wearing clothes and were embarrassed. So they sewed fig leaves together to cover themselves. When the cool evening breezes were blowing, Adam and Eve heard God walking about in the garden.
"Hide!"
So they hid from God among the trees. Then God called to Adam, "Where are you?" Adam said, "I heard you walking in the garden, so I hid. I was afraid because I was naked." "Who told you that you were naked?" God asked. "Did you eat from the tree I told you not to eat from?" Adam said, "It was the woman you gave me who gave me the fruit, and I ate it." Then God asked Eve, "What have you done?" "The serpent tricked me," she replied. "That's why I ate it." Then God punished the serpent by making it so he would crawl on his belly from then on. He told Eve that she would have great pain in her life. Then God said to Adam that because he listened to Eve and did not obey what God had told him to do, his life would be very difficult. He would have to work hard to get food to eat, God said, "For you were made from dust, and to dust you will return." Then God made them clothing from the animals, but God knew that Adam and Eve could no longer live in the garden because of their sin, so he sent them away and closed up the garden.
You can have self-control. Hey guys, it's me again, Douglas. And man, I've been learning so many cool things about animals. I love learning animal facts. They're really fun to learn about all the cool things that God has made. Do you guys know what an instinct is? An instinct is something that you know how to do, and it's something that you really, really want to do. A lot of animals have really interesting instincts, like little baby horses, baby ponies. They can run really quickly. You know, a little baby person, they can't even crawl for months and months and months, but it doesn't take very long at all for a little horse baby, a little pony, to get up and start running around. That's something that is inside of them, and they just know what they want to do, and they can do it. That's an instinct that they have. And like birds, a lot of birds, they have an instinct to fly south for the winter, and there's like whales, you know, they travel around throughout the ocean miles and miles and miles, hundreds and hundreds, sometimes thousands of miles, and they always go to the same place that whales have been going for thousands of years, and they just instinctually know what to do. And you know, there are some people that say that we are just like animals, and I would kind of agree with them. We're a little bit like animals because, you know, God made animals and God made us. But there's a big difference between animals and people. Do you know what one of the biggest differences is? First of all, we've got a soul. You know, God breathed life into Adam, and then there was Eve, and they had kids and kids and kids and kids and kids all down through all the people ever. People are made in the image of God. Animals aren't made in the image of God, just people. But you know, the other thing is that because we're not just animals, we can choose to listen to our hearts and souls and listen to the Holy Spirit instead of just doing what our body wants to do. The wrong thing. You know, a monkey just wants a banana, and it doesn't care how it gets it. And that's kind of like you and me. You know, we want what we want, and we don't always care how we get it. But you're not a monkey. You are a child of God. There is a right way to do things, and there's a wrong way to do things. There's a right way that God wants us to live, and there's a wrong way that often we want to live. You can go against your instincts to steal and to lie and to cheat. And you can make the right choice to show kindness and to share and to love. God has given you the ability to have self-control. To control yourself, to do the things that God wants you to do. So my challenge to you guys today is live according to the Spirit. Do what it is that God wants you to do and show self-control. Because God made you to be so much more than an animal. You are a child of God.
I love to read the Bible. Loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. When I read the Bible, it tells me how to live. When I read the Bible, it tells me He forgives. 'Cause yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so. When I read the Bible, it shows me how to love. And when I read the Bible, it makes me think of how, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me.
Hey, Gus. Hi, friends. Welcome to Scupperton Safari Park.
Yeah, welcome.
Gus, what's wrong?
The food spilled over and it's all ruined.
Oh, no. What happened?
The zebras ran by and knocked it over. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
Well, it's okay, Gus. Here, let me help you clean up.
Wait, you aren't mad?
No, why would I be mad? Mistakes happen all the time. There's nothing to get mad about.
Oh.
Gus, what's wrong?
I lied. It wasn't the zebras. It was me. I I thought I saw a lion in the bushes and I screamed and I knocked over all the food.
Oh, well, Gus, thank you for telling me. You know, I forgive you for lying to me.
You do? Why?
Because we all sin sometimes. You know, we do and we think things that God doesn't like. And we should be punished for those sins, but Jesus takes the punishment for us. So why would I get mad at you when there are bad things that I've done too?
I didn't know that other people did bad things. I just thought it was me.
No, Gus, it's not just you. You know, nobody is perfect except for God. Jesus is the only person who never sinned the entire time that he was on earth. And God knows that, and he forgives us when we ask him to because he loves us very much.
So I can ask God to forgive me for lying to you, and he will?
Yes, he will. Now, how about we go on a safari?
Really? You're gonna let me go even after I did all that bad stuff?
Of course. Come on.
Wow. Oh, wait. Let's not go see any of the lions or tigers or panthers, okay? But yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Yay! Okay.
Now, Gus, remember, on a safari, we look out for animals in their natural homes. So keep a close eye out for any animals.
Got it. And if we run into any lions, drive away as fast as you can, while still being safe, of course.
Got it. Look at that giraffe.
Oh, yeah. It's so cute. And safe looking. Hey, do they have any families?
Well, giraffes live in groups called towers, and there are about 15 giraffes in those towers.
Wow. That's a lot of giraffe friends. Oh, hey, what's that?
Where?
Over there.
Those are chimpanzees.
Aw, they're giving each other a hug.
Isn't that nice? You know, chimpanzees do a lot of the same things we do. They make mistakes too, and they get into fights with each other, and they even know how to forgive, and they make up with each other too.
Oh, really? I mean, I guess if chimpanzees can do it, I guess I can too.
That's good, Gus. Do you know they do fun things and laugh when something's really funny? And they even talk using sign language.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, God's creation is amazing. Hey, let's go back to Safari Park. I heard there's a pride of lions up ahead.
Ah, let's get out of here! Go! Mush! Get out! Let's go! Bye, giraffes! Thanks for taking me on a safari. I had fun!
Yeah, me too.
And thank you for forgiving me and teaching me that I can ask God for forgiveness too.
No problem, Gus. Friends, thanks for joining us on our safari today. Remember that you can ask God to forgive you for your sins. He loves you so much.
And so do we.
We'll see you back here next time at Safari Park.
Bye.